the Lord Jesus Christ be with you tonight. Friends, as a faith community, 1 year later, we are still scattered as the disciples were at the time of the crucifixion. But we join together tonight in heart and in spirit to share in a time of Tenebrae. My name is Anna Lehman Knox, and I'm one of the pastors of Camp Hill UMC's Community of Faith, and I'm here tonight sharing in this experience with my husband Simon as we together celebrate that we all can gather tonight with church family, both virtually and in person. Tenebrae is the Latin word for darkness or shadows. And each year, this service commemorates the last days of the life of Jesus, who we believe to be the greatest light of the world. And so I invite you now, if you haven't done so already, to light 7 candles around you, or to turn on 7 lights that are easily reached, so that at the beginning of our walk through Christ's story, there is a blaze of his light, as there is before us tonight. And as we step through the story together, hearing scriptures that walk us closer and closer to the moment of crucifixion, after each of the 7 scripture readings, I invite you to turn off a light or extinguish a candle so that slowly your home and you will also see that in our home, it becomes more deeply wrapped in darkness. When we reach the end of our time together, after the final scripture and a brief song for meditation, we will extinguish the last candle, which is the Christ candle, as we remember the moment of Jesus' death. And I invite you to sit in spirit together in the silent darkness for 6 minutes, the number of hours that the Gospel of Mark indicates that Christ hung on the cross. After that time, the live stream will end, and you are free to continue to meditate in the shadows of the evening and throughout Holy Saturday until we meet again on Easter for a time of resurrection. And this year, that will start with an outdoor sunrise service at 6:30 a.m. in the church courtyard, our classic Easter celebration, live stream worship, and in person will happen at 9:30, and then there will be an 11 a.m. modern worship service as well. But as we spend this time in the shadows together tonight, we recognize that each of us has a shadow side. And so this is an opportunity to share in our humanity, and also to seek Christ's holiness in the midst of grief and suffering together through prayer, through music, and through the hearing of scripture. And so please do sing along with the songs and simply enjoy them as well for your meditation. But let's begin together with prayer. God, on this dark night, as the shadows deepen, we come to be present with Jesus. With the glory of Palm Sunday behind us and the victory of Easter not yet come, we will sit together in this space with our breaking, our broken hearts, in this world that is at once so beautiful and holy and tragic. We seek to be present tonight with all who suffer. In the dark valleys of life, when sorrow threatens to overwhelm us, we long for a safe and sacred space to sit with our grief and our questions. And so Jesus Christ, our holy friend, we know that you are here with us. Let us be here with you. Amen. As we pray the prayer together that Jesus has taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, in the name of the compassionate Christ, you are forgiven. For God has declared, I forgive your evil ways and remember your sins no more. And so as a forgiven people, let us pray once again. Holy, loving, and suffering God, give us eyes to see the injustice and the suffering that abound. Give us hearts to feel the depth of this world's brokenness. And give us ears now to bear the silence and to hear the words of your passion. Amen. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be distressed and troubled. He said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and stay awake with me." Going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed, "Abba, Father, if it is possible, take this cup from me. Yet not what I want, but what you want." In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground. When he got up from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping because of grief. And he said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Could you not stay awake with me 1 hour?"
Thank you. While Jesus was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard." At once he came up to Jesus and said, "Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said, "Friend, do what you are here to do." Then they laid hands on him and arrested him.
One of them struck the slave of the high priest with his sword, cutting off his ear. But Jesus said, "No more of this." And he touched his ear and healed him. Then Jesus said to the chief priests, the officers of the temple guard, and the elders who had come for him, "Have you come out with swords and clubs as if I were a bandit? When I was with you day after day in the temple, you did not lay hands on me. But this is your hour and the power of darkness." Then all the disciples deserted him and fled.
Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard. A servant girl came to him and said, "You were also with Jesus the Galilean." But he denied it before all of them, saying, "I do not know what you are talking about." When he went out to the porch, another servant girl saw him, and she said to the bystanders, "This man was with Jesus of Nazareth." Again he denied it with an oath, "I do not know the man." After a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter, "Certainly, you are also one of them, for your accent betrays you." Then Peter began to curse, and he swore an oath, "I do not know the man." At that moment, the cock crowed. Then Peter remembered what Jesus had said, "Before the cock crows, you will deny me three times." And he went out and wept bitterly.
Now, at the festival, the governor was accustomed to release a prisoner for the crowd, anyone whom they wanted. At that time, they had a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So after they had gathered, Pilate said to them, "Whom do you want me to release for you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called the Messiah?" For he realized that it was out of jealousy that they had handed him over. While he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him, "Have nothing to do with that innocent man, for today I have suffered a great deal because of a dream about him." Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowds to ask for Barabbas and to have Jesus killed. The governor again said to them, "Which of the two do you want me to release for you?" And they said, "Barabbas." Pilate said to them, "Then what should I do with Jesus, who is called the Messiah?" They shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him!" When Pilate saw that he could do nothing, he took some water and washed his hands before the crowd, saying, "I am innocent of this man's blood. It is your responsibility." The people as a whole answered, "His blood will be on us and on our children." So he released Barabbas for them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified.
Then the governor's soldiers took Jesus into the palace and gathered the whole company of soldiers around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him and then twisted together a crown of thorns and put it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand and knelt in front of him and mocked him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. They spat on him and took the staff and struck him on the head again and again. After they had mocked him, they took off the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him.
What one. They brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. They offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but when he tasted it, he would not drink it. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And about 3:00, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani?" That is, my God, why have you forsaken me? When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "This man is calling for Elijah." At once, one of them ran and got a sponge, filled it with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." Then Jesus cried again with a loud voice and breathed his last.
God of salvation, you change.